Majority is looming. So the discussion should now be, what can we do to prevent it or to mitigate its effect on Nigerians? Because there'll be, like you say, 200 million Nigerians still looking for food.
Sure. Mandela was not the best dancer in the world. But because Mandela danced here, the South Africans won the African Cup of Nations. Here, the body languages of a leader brings out the spirit of entrepreneurship in the citizens here. Whatever anything it takes, we need to bring back the confidence of Nigerian farmers. We need to give them what they require. We need to bring in the MIE. This requirement, you give them impute. We need to rejig the entire whole Ministry of Agriculture. We need to bring in there has to be a relationship between the Ministry of Agriculture, Environment, Water Resources together. How can a 250 million population country be dependent on rain-fed agriculture? Why will we not have mechanization dovetail to our food production? You cannot imagine this.
Mr. Medline,
as I speak with you,
we have several river basins around Nigeria. Are they not functioning anymore?
No. The river basins were established by the time of Sadauna. Some of them were done by Sadauna and all that there. Let's take, for instance, the Kura in Kano, where they call the rice community. If you're a policeman and you are sent to Kura, you play draft until you are transferred out of the place. Because of water body in Kura, in Kano State here, every child, every young man, every mother, every father is engaged into all-year-round farming activities. Crime is low. One of the biggest ways that we could actually would have engaged a lot of Nigerian youth today, the biggest employer of labor is agriculture. Now, this river basin today have not been desilted. The embankment has been broken. Who knows that Zamfara alone have more than 35 dams, but they're not working. From Talata, Mafara, Bukuyum, Safe, up to Funtua. But they're all broken. They've been covered by silt. Nobody has desilted them.
Okay,
and this is where we have one of our finest cotton coming out from, where we have one of the biggest tatashi coming in from here. Plateau State, the only state in Nigeria that produce Irish potato is Plateau State. But as I speak with you, the potato farmers are scared of going to farm. Just 3 days or 4 days ago, we lost over 12 people where they are doing the potato cultivation, Irish potato cultivation. Hmm. It's sad.
No, Mr. Lajalo, the same question to you. So what is the way forward? Are we just going to sit back and wait for starvation to kill us?
I think government needs to be serious. That's the issue. We need to leave politics out of agriculture. Like we have said, if you look at it, from what he's saying, the major bane of agriculture, even the so-called food basket of Nigeria now, is the Hausa Fulani, if I can use herdsmen, farmers issue. So, I mean, what government needs to do is to come out with is an institutional framework that they have to come out with an institutional framework such that we come up with idea of ranching. It makes life easy for everybody. If you look at it, come to think of it, we are telling farmers, take up new, improved method of agriculture. Why are we not saying the same thing to the same? I remember the minister was saying some days ago that the routes that they've been using from independence is the same routes, and they've suddenly blocked those routes. I mean, I cannot imagine that in this age and time. In 1960, we are still talking of that year. So we need to really sit down and formulate policies that will make us, I mean, you can't, you said something the other time, which I needed to come back to, and you said that, well, how come, I mean, you have to provide this for yourself. You have to provide security for myself on the farm, provide water to do my stuff and all that. If you look at it, it forms part of your cost of doing business. So he is going to take this to the market with others. So how do you sell? So it becomes a real problem. So we need to really sit down and come up with policies to determine whether I really want to take this insecurity out of our, I mean, food security. We need to be very careful about that. So that is why I'm saying that it is government. It's not only government. I mean, I must confess, But government must create an enabling environment for agriculture to thrive, whether it's livestock or whether it's, what is it called, arable cropping. So that is the way I...
Do you all have some kind of association that dialogues with government and brings all this to the...
Oh, yes, there are associations, even at the local level, that you dialogue with government. Yes, we do. We do. Even in my own locality, we meet
and
farmers.
No kind of positive reaction?
Oh, yes. I mean, you talk to them, but they will tell you, I mean, for instance, the budget allocation now, I mean, even looking at it holistically, how much was implemented of the so-called budget? Budget is, I have expenditure, I have budgets, I have revenue. They will tell you that it's not enough revenue to do whatever. Once it rains in my area, you don't go to farm because there's a river. Yes, there's a river. Once it rains, there is no farming that day. So, I mean, what do you do?
Yeah, but you're praying for rain to come so that your crops will grow. If rain has come and you can't even go to work.
You can't even, so you can't get there. So because, I mean, you have to go by. Sorry to point out, this cut, I had it because I fell off a bike going to my farm.
During the rains?
No, regular time. I'm just telling you, but you will need to
take... Maybe you need a horse.
Maybe that is where we are going to. So you will need to really look at how to develop the infrastructure. That's what government should do. Develop infrastructure. Somebody was telling me storage. People are not even going to, they are not becoming primary farmers anymore. Everybody wants to do processing now. So we do, because I mean, you are probably producing to get spoilt. The middlemen are the ones taking this thing off you. And once you put these things, whether it's cassava or it's maize, it's a problem. You don't get it to sell. So it's a major issue. So basically, government should try and still put more money creating infrastructure. Logistics, I mean, have roads, motorable roads, maybe probably have rails that can move this stuff from where they are, then storage, then processing. So it will encourage people to do this issue.
These new railroads, are they going to help in any way?
Oh, yes, railroad. If they are railroads, where are the feeder roads to get to the railroads? So it's a major issue. So
every solution you think of, there's still a but.
Yes, that is what I'm saying. So we need to really look at. Agriculture has the potential of employing at least 70% of Nigeria very well. We need to take people out of poverty.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Oh. Now, we need to go now. We need to go now. So, Mr. Medline, I'd like your last word on this, please.
Well, my last word in this is that no nation plays politics with his food. Let's rejig. And then and come up with a more proper, acceptable strategy so that this great nation does not turn to Haiti. And my condolence to the people of Benue State and Taraba, Adamawa, the biggest victim of this crisis and institutional failure in these countries that have paid the price are the farmers. My heart goes out to them, and I pray that God will give them, the families give them a good heart to take the losses that happened in this
time. Thank you. Yeah. Mr. Lajolo.
My last word is that we should, government should still try and do more. And we are begging them to at least put more money. $118 billion in agriculture is not enough. That's less than 2% of the budget. When the Maputo Declaration says it should be 10%, I know it's a function of the revenue. But if you can have all these things where you create the environment, people will be able to go to farms, create security on the farm, put more extension officers on the road. Okay. It makes life easy for everybody. So that's the only way we can, increase food productivity. That's the way I see it.
Thank you very much. We have been chatting with an agricultural practitioner, Mr. Chedrack Madlion, who spoke to us from our studio in Abuja, and Mr. Abimbola Olajolo, who's an Greek entrepreneur. We were talking food security. Thank you very much, both of you, for coming to share your insight with us this morning. Sunrise will be right back with another interesting conversation. Please make sure you join us.